Hello students, in this video we are going to study the remaining part of the chapter number 13. The chapter name is Motion and Time, class 7, subject Science and CERT. So before starting that, let me recall what we had seen in the previous video of this chapter. So in this starting we had seen different kinds of motion, that is linear motion, then after we had seen circular motion and periodic motion. And we had also seen some of the examples of these different kinds of motion. Then after we had seen that how we can compare that whether any object is faster or slower than the other objects. So we had seen that the object which covers the maximum distance in a given time or in a definite time, so we can say that that object is faster or more speedy than the other objects. Then after we had seen that to compare or to say that whether any object is faster or slower than the other objects, we require the one quantity that is known as the speed. So from this speed we can say that which object is faster or slower than the other objects. So in this speed we had seen that the distance covered by any vehicle or any object in a unit time is known as the speed of that object. So that is known as the speed of the object, and we had also seen the formula for speed, that is speed is equal to total distance covered by the object divided by the total time taken to cover that distance. So that we had seen. Then after we had seen that to find the speeds, we require to measure the distance or to measure the time. So how to measure the distance, that we had already studied in the previous class. So here in this chapter we had seen next topic in that how to measure the time, that is measurement of time. So in that we had seen that before the invention of these quartz clocks which we are using nowadays, there were another clocks were there which is known as the pendulum clock, or which is work on the principle of pendulum. So in that we had also seen what is pendulum, what is oscillation of that pendulum, and what is the time period. So in that we had also seen that for an equal length of a pendulum, the time period is always equal. Then after, now we had measured the time and the distance. In that one quantity we are taking the constant. In that we had also seen there is the two types of motions are there, that is uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So uniform motion, that means if the object is moving in a linear path or in a straight line with a constant speed, then we can say that that object is in a uniform motion. And if that object is not moving in a with a constant speed or it keeps changing its speed, then we can say that that object is in non-uniform motion. Then after we had seen how to measure this speed. So through one activity we had seen, or for the given time we had measured the distance, and from that measured distance we had calculated the speed of the different objects. So now let me continue on the chapter. So these are the things we had seen for slow or fast. Then after we defined the quantity, that is speed. Then we had seen how to measure the time, measurement of time, and in that we had also seen the different units for the time and speed. This one pendulum we had seen, the oscillation and time period for the pendulum, the units of time and speed, and their conversation from one unit to another unit, or their comparison. Then after we had measured the speed of different objects. So till now we had seen these are the things. From this table we had left from the last video. So now let me continue. Here one table is given to you. The fastest speed that some animals can attain. Here's the speed of some living organisms is given to you. The speed in kilometer per hour is given to you. We have to convert the speed into meter per second. So first it is given to you, that is about falcon. Falcon is a bird, or you can say the fastest bird on the earth. When it dives from the height, it travels or it dives with the speed of 320 km per hour. That means it can attain the 300, or it can cover the distance of 320 km in 1 hour. So that is the fastest bird on the earth. So the speed of the falcon is 320 kilometer per hour. And then after we had to convert that into meter per second. So for that, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So here in the numerator we had multiplied with the 1000. And here you can see that the r is the denominator. So 1 hour is equal to 3600 seconds. Or you can say 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So first we had converted into 60. Minutes, so divided, we had here divided with 60, and then after we had converted meter into second, so again we had divided with the 60. So that means we had first converted hour into minute, and then after we had converted this minute into second. So 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, and 1 minute is equal to, we know that, 60 seconds. So here in denominator we had got 2 times 60, that means 60 multiplied by 60. In place of that you can also write 3600 seconds. Now next speed is given to you of cheetah. Its speed is 112 km per hour. Now we have to convert that into meter per second. So here we have to multiply 112 with 1000, and then we have to divide it with 60 multiplied by 60. So 1 zeros cancel. So here you can see, write that 1120 divided by 6 is 36. So if you will solve this, then you will get the speed in meter per second. Same like that, you have to convert the speed for all of these organisms or living organisms or animals. That is, for bluefish, the speed of bluefish is 40 to 46 kilometer per hour. Same, you have to convert this into meter per second like this. Then you have to multiply with 1000 and divide it by 3600. The speed of rabbit is 56 kilometer per hour. The squirrel speed is 19 kilometer per hour. The domestic mouse, the mouse which we have found in our house, that is domestic mouse, so its speed is 11 kilometer per hour. So you have to again convert the meter per second. You have to fill this table on your own. Next is human. So our speed is 40 km per hour. Next is giant tortoise. Tortoise, the speed of tortoise is 0.27 km per hour. So that means in 1 hour it covers only 0.27 km. Next is snail. It is the slowest organism. So its speed is 0.05 km per hour. So this is the speed of the different living organisms. You have to just convert it into meter per second. So this we had left, or you have to convert this table. Here you can see the variation in this speed. The falcon speed is 320 km per hour, whereas snail speed is 0.05 km per hour. That means the difference between these two is very long. So now let me see which unit is convenient to measure the speed of different organisms or different objects. So rockets launching satellites into Earth orbit often attains the speed up to 8 km per second. The rockets which launch the satellites in our Earth orbit, so they attain or they get the speed of 8 km per second. That means in 1 second they can attain the speed of 8 km. They are traveling with the speed of 8 km per second. And the other hand, the tortoise can move only with a speed of about 8 cm in a second. On the other side, the tortoise is very slow. It covers only 8 cm in 1 second. So now can you calculate how fast is the rocket as compared to the tortoise? So there is the wide variation in the speed of these different organisms. So once you know the speed of an object, you can also find the distance which is moved by that object in a given time. We have seen that speed is equal to distance divided by time. So this we have seen that speed is equal to distance divided by time. So if we know the speed and we want to find the distance, we want to find this distance, then we can find this distance. If the speed and the time is given to you, then distance is equal to, this is here in denominator, so if we will shift it in the opposite side of the equal to, it multiplied by time. So we can count the distance covered by an object by the speed multiplied by time. Same like that, we can also count this time. So let me see the formula for that. So you can also find the time of an object would take to cover the distance while moving with a given speed. If the speed is given to you and distance is given to you, then you can find this time. How? So here the formula for that is given to you. Time taken is equal to distance divided by speed. If we are shifting this time here, it will come into numerator and this will come into denominator. That means time is equal to distance divided by speed. So by this we can count the time taken by an object to cover particular distance. So now Bhuja wants to know whether there is any device that measures this speed. So yes, there are certain devices which measures this speed. So now let me find which kind of devices measure this speed or the distance of any object, distance covered by any object. So you might have seen a meter which is fitted on the top of a scooter or motorcycle. You have find or you might have noticed the meter which is there on the head of the scooter or motorcycle or on the dashboard of the car. So similarly, the meters can be seen on the dashboard of cars, buses and other vehicles. Here in the next figure it is shown to you, the dashboard of car. Then after you have to note the meter which has written kilometer per hour on that meter, and this is known as the speedometer. Let me see the picture of the speedometer. Here it is shown to you, this one or this one. Here kilometer per hour is written on this meter, so it is known as the speedometer and it records the speed of the object. Starting from here, 0 to here, it is shown to you up to 140. So that means if this speed is 120, then it covers 120 km in 1 hour. So this shows the speed of an object and that is known as the speedometer. And here you can see that another meter is also shown to you on which it is written to kilometer. So it is known as the odometer, which measures the distance covered by the object. It shows the kilometer, that how many kilometers have traveled that object or that vehicle. So that is known as the odometer and this one is known as the speedometer. So speedometer measures the speed directly in kilometer per hour, and there is also another meter that measures the distance moved by the vehicle that we had seen already. So this meter is known as the odometer. The meter on which the kilometer is only written, that meter is known as the odometer. So now while going to any places through the vehicle, find what is the distance covered by that vehicle and what is the speed at a particular time. Here one example is given to you about Paheri. So while going for a school picnic, Paheri decided to note the reading on the odometer of a bus after every 30 minutes till the end of the journey. She decided to measure the distance, how much distance is covered by the bus after every 30 minutes. So he measured that and later on she recorded a reading on the table. Here on table it is given to be shown to you, at 8 a.m. they started their journey. So the distance at starting point reading on the odometer was 36,540 km. So the distance from starting point it will be 0. At 8:30 the distance shows like this on the odometer reading. So for that, or to count how much distance is covered by the bus, you have to subtract or you have to find the distance between these two readings, that means 36,560 minus 36,540. So you will get the 20 km. So that means in 30 minutes the bus travels 20 km of distance. Same like that for 9 a.m. the bus travels 40 km, at 9:30 it travels the 60 km and at 10 a.m. it travels the distance of 80 km. So this is the reading of Paheri, that how much distance is covered by the bus. So now can you tell that how far was the picnic spot from this school? So as in the table we had seen that in starting it was 0 and at the end it was 80. So that means the distance between the school and picnic spot it was 80 kilometers. 80 minus 0 means 80 kilometers. Now looking at, can you calculate the speed of the bus? So yes, you can calculate that the speed of the bus. Why? Because the distance is given to you and time is given to you. So you can also calculate the speed. How? So in first 30 minutes, here the time period duration is 30 minutes and the distance traveled by the bus is 20 kilometers. So to find the or to count the speed, you have to first take the distance covered by the bus, that is 20 kilometers, divided by the time taken by that bus, that is 30 minutes. So 20 divided by 30 minutes, so this will become your speed. So it will 2 by 3 kilometers per minute. So the speed of the bus in the first 30 minutes, it will be like this. Or you can give the simplification for this also. So this is how we can also calculate the speed of the bus. So now, Pooja asked Paheli whether she can tell how far they would have travelled till 9:45 a.m. So now let me see in the table. Here you can see that the time 9:45 is not given. So we cannot say that till 9:45 how much distance is covered by the bus. So we cannot say this by the table. So now Paheli had no answer for this question. They went to the teacher and she told them that one way to solve this problem is to plot the distance time graph. This distance time graph. And now let me find out how to draw this graph. So here next topic is distance time graph. To find or to form the distance, how much distance is covered by any object in a particular or an instant or time, we have to require or we have to draw the distance time graph. So it will help you to give the information about the distance covered by any object or the time taken by any object to cover particular distance. So that is distance time graph. So that we will study in the next video. So in this video we have seen about speedometer, odometer, how to calculate the speed and the conversion of different units of the speed. The remaining part we will study in the next video. Thank you.